Abigail of the Black Book Space. If you are seeing this video on time, you have missed the last Epic Book Chat. Really, really sad for you, but you know, it was a really great time. We got to talk about the other black girls, so stay tuned for the next one. But today, we're going to be talking about three amazing books that are spiritual in nature, written by black authors, all about changing your mindset, forgiveness, really getting into that wonderful spiritual side, letting go of those limiting beliefs. That's what we're going to be talking about today, and have three wonderful books to talk to you about. So stay tuned. So let's get into these books. I'm going to talk about the one that I've known about the longest, was introduced to the furthest back in my life first, and that one is Sacred Women by Queen Afua. It is an amazing book. Queen Afua is like a great authority in the black community, or in the community at large, talking about holistic health. So I knew about Queen Afua before I even decided to go to naturopathic medical school, and she is all about health from the inside out. So she talks about one of my favorite things in her book, belly dancing, which is a really great way to release all that stress that we carry in the womb, open that sacral chakra. She talks about all of that stuff before it was cool. She had wonderful gatherings where people would get together and drink green juice all day, meditate. She is, I feel like, the epitome of just calm, beauty, and just queenliness. She's just like royalty. So that's why she's called Queen of Love. This book is called Sacred Women. I'm really excited because I'm going to be reading this book with a group very soon, which will be great, because to be honest, I have never gone completely through the entire book, but each time I read it, I learn a little bit more. Like I said, it talks a lot about belly dancing. One of my favorite things in here is about making clay poultices for your skin and your body. I have a lot of her products, which are really great for your scalp, releasing all those toxins, including toxins that you take in from like music and things like that. Talked about a book that her son wrote about the green juice diet. This woman lives and breathes this lifestyle, so I highly recommend you grab yourself a copy of this book and read it with your book club friends. It may be one that we celebrate at the Epic Book Chat at some time or another. It's a little deep and it's quite a long book, and it's one of those books where you have to put things into practice, right? It's not just a book that you read and kind of throw aside. It's kind of like a guide for life. So highly recommend it if you are on your spiritual journey this summer, trying to add a lot of wonder and beauty into your life. This is a great book for you to pick up. Probably find it at your local library. That's where I found my first copy, and then I decided to purchase one as well because I like to write in my books. I can't write in the books in the library, from the library. So that is why I got a copy of this one. Check it out and let me know what you think. Have you read this book? If you have, comment what you thought about it. What is your biggest takeaway from this book? What would you tell a younger version of yourself who had not yet read this book? What would you tell her about this book? Comment below and tell us. This next book has a very special place in my heart because it's by the great Iyanla Vanzant. I love Iyanla. So this book is about forgiveness. 21 Days to Forgive Everyone for Everything. Now, when we say everyone, that includes yourself. It talks about forgiving yourself for things in this book. Your mother, your father, anybody who has wronged you. I really need to go through this book again. So she talks about why it's important to forgive. She says in here, these are some of the quotes. You might be asking yourself, why would I want to practice forgiveness? The answer is simple. It's always a simple answer, right? Practice develops skill. Skill leads to mastery. When you master the practice of forgiveness, it becomes as natural as breathing. And when you know how to forgive, you eliminate excess mental and emotional weight that keeps you stuck in repetitive situations, circumstances, and experiences that are not healthy or productive. So forgiving really helps you to release limiting beliefs. One of the best ways to do that, which I learned from this book, is EFT tapping. This is the first time in my life that I'd ever heard about this, and ever since then, I've been pretty decently consistent with having a tapping practice when I get really frustrated about something. Tapping, I will put a link to how to do that in a video below because I'm not an expert and I don't want to lead anybody in the wrong direction. But she actually takes you through how to do the process in this book, where she says you're tapping 7 times on each meridian point, and she points out the meridian points in here, or repeating out loud either the statements below or your reminder phrases. So she has all of these excited because another person I just met has read it as well, and I'm really excited about talking to her about her experience with this book because she's gone through it more than one time. And it is this one, We Should All Be Millionaires by Rochelle Rogers. It's an amazing book because it talks about changing your mindset as a woman when it comes to making money, managing money, and everything like that. To me, that is very spiritual. I think everything, honestly, is spiritual, but this book talks about becoming a millionaire, becoming wealthy and healthy in all those regions of your life, by changing your mindset, deciding for yourself that you are the standard of success, and the things that you want are not something that you should feel guilty about because you're a woman, because you're this or that or the other. It really breaks everything down and gives you really manageable steps on how to manage your money and up level, go to that next level in your business. She talks about forgiveness too. She says here, so what's our next move? Our next move is forgiveness. I'm not talking about forgiving the media or the government. Funk that. I'm talking about ourselves. It's time to forgive ourselves for thinking we're not good with money. These thoughts are not manifesting out of thin air. No, these thoughts are the result of millennia of conditioning that makes us believe building wealth and becoming a millionaire is out of reach for us. So she's saying, obviously, over time, the system has really been set up against us. It's hypnotic everywhere. They're hypnotizing us into believing things that are opposite of what we should be believing. It's time to forgive ourselves for allowing ourselves to believe that. So much like Iyanla Van Zandt's book, she talks about forgiveness, which is a very spiritual practice. You know, it takes a lot of grit and spirit and determination to decide that you're going to forgive someone, especially like an entire system that was built against you. So I love this book, and I think it is very spiritual, even though she may or may not have intended that way. I have no idea. That's how I feel about it. So these are the three books that I highly recommend you get your hands on if you're looking to start or just add something to your spiritual journey as a Black woman or as anybody, because these authors are great authors. They write really well. They have wonderful things to share with all of us about releasing limiting beliefs, changing your mindset so that you can pull all of that positivity and all those goodies that you deserve back into your life, right? Because we talked about our affirmations a few weeks ago. A lot of times it's hard to really believe those affirmations if you still have those limiting beliefs blocking you in the way. That is what I have found in my practice. Once I start releasing those limiting beliefs, things get easier and easier. It's not quite perfect by any means, but it's a lot easier than it was before. So I highly recommend you check out these books for that reason. Do something that brings you joy today, and I will see you next time. Please make sure to subscribe to the channel and stay tuned for the date for the next epic book chat. Which book do you think we should read next? Comment in the comments below. Bye!